What's up, Pythoners? This is Vishesh Dwivedi and welcome back to Class 11, Chapter 5, Getting Started with Python series. In the last video, we ended our discussion with the topic, deciding which Python data type to use in which scenario. If you have not watched any of the previous videos of this series, I highly recommend you do so, as the content taught in this video will be related to the previous ones. You can find the link to the playlist in this video's description. Now, let's talk about a concept in Python called operators. Operators in Python are very similar to how mathematical operators work. Let's take addition and subtraction as an example. Each operator in math has a symbol, like we have the plus sign for addition and minus sign for subtraction. Each operator performs a specific function, like addition operator adds numbers, and subtraction operator subtracts numbers. Each operator may be commutative or may not be commutative. Like in case of addition, for any two numbers a and b, a plus b will always be equal to b plus a. But in the case of subtraction, a minus b will not be equal to b minus a. Each operator may work on a variety of data, like addition and subtraction in math can work on whole numbers, integers, decimals, and all real numbers. Similarly, Python also has its own set of operators that are denoted by a sign, perform any action, may or may not be commutative, and may work with a variety of data types. So today, we will start with understanding the operators within Python that are commonly used by programmers and developers to create logic. Operators can be divided into five types on the basis of the operation they perform. The five types are arithmetic operators, relational operators, assignment operators, logical operators, and identity operators. For today's video, we are going to focus only on arithmetic operators and will discuss more operators in future videos. Arithmetic operators, as the name suggests, are the operators that perform arithmetic operations. There are seven types of arithmetic operators in Python, namely addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus, floor division, and exponent. As you may have guessed from the name itself, many of these operators are derived from mathematical operators, and they also perform functions similar to the math operators, but with a few differences. Arithmetic operators in itself are easy to understand as long as you learn all the use cases of each operator. With this clear, let's discuss these operators one by one. Addition operator is used to add two numbers and is denoted by the plus sign. It can be used on integers, floats, and also strings, which is a special case we will talk about in a minute. For this demo, let's create a few variables named num1, num2, float1, and float2 and assign them some values. num1 and num2 will have integer values and float1 and float2 will have float values. There are three main rules for addition in Python with integer and float. Number 1, adding two integers always gives an integer. Number 2, adding two floats always gives a float. And number 3, as adding a float and an integer always gives a float. These three rules remain the same for any integer or float value. Since addition is commutative in nature, if we add two numbers in any order, the result will remain the same. Let's create two more variables, string1 and string2, both storing string values. In Python, addition operator can also be used with strings. The rule for that is adding two strings will join or concatenate the two strings and return it as shown here. This rule also remains the same for any string value. One thing to note here is that if you try to add a string with an integer or float, Python will give a type error indicating that this is not possible. With the addition operator clear, let's move on to the subtraction operator. Subtraction operator is used to subtract two numbers and is denoted by minus sign. It can be used on integers and floats. Let's again create four variables, num1, num2, float1 and float2, and assign them values. The rules for subtraction remain similar to that of addition. Number 1, subtracting two integers always gives an integer. Number 2, subtracting two floats always gives a float. And number 3, subtracting a float and an integer always gives a float. These three rules remain the same for all integer and floats. Since subtraction is not commutative, the result of using this operator in Python changes based on which value is written to the left and right. For example, if we write num1 minus num2, it will give different results than num2 minus num1. Unlike addition, subtraction does not work on strings. So if we try to subtract two strings, we get a type error. With the subtraction operator done, let's move on to the multiplication operator. Multiplication operator is used to multiply two numbers and is denoted by hashtag sign. It can be used on integers, floats and string. Let's create five variables, num1, num2, float1, float2 and string1, and assign them values. The rules for multiplication remain similar to that of previous operators. Number 1, multiplying two integers always gives an integer. Number 2, multiplying two floats always gives a float. And number 3, multiplying an integer and a float always gives a float. These rules remain the same for all integers and floats. Since multiplication is commutative, the result of multiplying two numbers remains the same irrespective of order. For example, num1 times num2 will give the exact same result as num2 times num1. Multiplication operator can also work with a string and an integer. In such a scenario, the operator will return a string which will contain the operand string joined by itself the operand number of times. For example, if I take a string str1 and multiply it by 2, you can see I get the result str1 str1, which is generated as str1 was joined by itself 2 times. This is a very nice trick to create very long string values without typing. I can multiply str1 with 20 and I get a very long string easily. One thing to note here is that you can only use integers for this trick. This won't work for float values. Also, you cannot use multiplication operator between two strings. With the multiplication operator covered, let's talk about the division operator. Division operator is used to divide two numbers and is denoted by slash sign. It can be used on integers and floats. Let's create four variables, num1, num2, float1 and float2, and assign them values. The rule for division operators is a bit different from previous operators. The result of dividing two numbers, be it integer or float, will always be float, even if the two numbers are completely divisible. These rules remain the same for all values of integers and float. Since division is not commutative, the result of this operator depends on the order in which operands are placed. For example, num1 divided by num2 will not be equal to num2 divided by num1. With the division operator clear, let's talk about the modulus operator. Modulus operator is used to find the remainder of division of two numbers, denoted by percentage sign. It can be used on integers and floats. Let's create four variables, num1, num2, float1 and float2, and assign them values. The rules for modulus operator remain similar to that of previous operators. Modulus of two integers always gives an integer. Modulus of two floats always gives a float. Modulus of an integer and a float always gives a float. This rule remains the same for all values of integers and floats. Since modulus is based on division and division is not commutative, the result of this operator depends on the order of which the operands are placed. For example, the result of num1 modulus num2 will not be equal to num2 modulus num1. With the modulus operator covered, let's talk about the floor division operator. Floor division operator, also called as integer division operator, is used to divide two numbers and get the quotient of the division as an integer. It works on integers and floats. Let's create four variables, num1, num2, float1 and float2, and assign them values. The rules for floor division operator remain similar to that of previous operator. Floor division of two integers always gives an integer. Floor division of two floats always gives a float. And floor division of an integer and a float always gives a float. And this operator is based on division. Therefore, the result of the operator depends on the order in which the operands are placed. For example, integer division between num1 and num2 will not be equal to the integer division between num2 and num1. With the floor division operator clear, let's discuss the last arithmetic operator left, the exponent operator. Exponent operator is used to find the result of a number raised to the power of another number. It works on integers and floats. Let's create four variables, num1, num2, float1 and float2, and assign them values. The rules for exponent operator remain similar to that of previous operators. Number 1, exponent of two integers always gives an integer. Number 2, exponent of two floats always gives a float. And number 3, exponent of an integer and a float always gives a float. The rule remains the same for any value of integer and float. Since the exponent operator is not commutative, the result of this operator depends on the order in which the operands are placed. For example, num1 exponent num2 will not be equal to num2 exponent num1. That's all for this video. In the next video of the series, I will cover the topic of relational operators. Until then, do make sure to revise all that you have learned today, as revision will make sure you remember it longer. In case of any doubts, don't forget to mention it down in the comment section below. With this, it's time for me to go. This is Vishesh Dwivedi signing off.